Hi, my name is Maddy and I'm an instructor with Wordfence. Today we're going to show you how to set up and run scans on your Wordfence protected sites. First, let's navigate to the Wordfence scans page. Here at the top, we see status circles for our scan status, malware signature status, and reputation check status. Hovering over these circles will show you what you can enable to reach 100% if they are not there already. Having Wordfence Premium on your site with high sensitivity scans enabled is the quickest way to be sure you're scanning your site as comprehensively as possible. Let's head over to the scan options and scheduling page to see some more options. First, we see the scan scheduling tab. Here, as a premium customer, you have the option to set scans to run a number of different ways, all of which allow you to set a preferred time. The custom option on the far right will give you complete control over the scan days and times. Under the scan scheduling tab, we see the basic scan type options and the general options sections where we can select what we would like the Wordfence scanner to process during scans. Using a standard scan is a good place to start on most sites. You might opt to enable the options for scan theme files against repository versions for changes and scan plugin files against repository versions for changes, which will have the scanner check the WordPress.org repository to make sure the plugin and theme files on your site have not changed in comparison to what we see for those versions on the repository. Keep in mind, with these options enabled, if you've modified your theme or plugins, you may see a modified theme file or modified plugin file scan result, which you could then review and ignore if you confirm you made the changes. You can also see false positives if a plugin author makes a change to a plugin or theme without releasing a new version. It is best to check with the plugin or theme author before repairing or making changes to a file after a scan. You might also consider enabling the option to scan files outside your WordPress installation. A regular Wordfence scan looks at the wp-admin, wp-content, wp-includes, as well as all subdirectories of those directories and all files in your root WordPress directory. When you enable this option, we scan all subdirectories of your WordPress installation, even if they are not a part of WordPress. This is a good option if you have directories unrelated to WordPress that you would like to scan for malicious code and infections. If you do not have this option enabled, you may notice a scan result that mentions skipped paths, which is alerting you that the scanner skipped over some directories during the scan process due to this option not being enabled. Let's head back over to the scan options and scheduling page and then back down at the bottom of the section we were at. We're going to click scan images, binary, and other files as if they were executable, although this option is typically disabled by default. If you enable this, and all the others we just went over, you will be running a high sensitivity scan. This is good in the event you suspect you have an infection on the site and want to scan for code hidden inside files that have an image extension or other extensions. Keep in mind, running high sensitivity scans will be more resource intensive and can possibly produce false positives, and we recommend using this option for occasional scans or on servers that have more resources available. Be sure to save any changes you made, and let's head back to the scan page and run a new scan with these settings. To start a new scan, we can click the Start New Scan button. Now that our scan is running, we can see our first three options, spam advertising checks, spam check, and blacklist check, go rather quickly. These are premium features checking to make sure the site is not producing spam and is not on any blacklists. If you'd like to read more about what each of these scan stages looks for, you can check the link to our documentation in the description of the video. As we can see here, our scan is all done and completed with no findings. Remember, to be safe, it is best to make a backup of the site or files before repairing or deleting them via the scanner. That is how to set up your scans in Wordfence. If you'd like more information about scan options, you can view our video here. Thanks for watching, and we look forward to securing your WordPress website.